here. GD is just a elimination round, and if you put yourself into the employer's place, so employer who is going to reach to any campus, who is coming to your campus to conduct certain placement drive, so their intention is to minimize their time, and they do keep most of the time for the interview. So GD is just a process of elimination for them. For you, if it is a process of elimination, then for you, it should be the process in which you want to go to the next level. You never want to be in the list of eliminated candidate. So you always want to be in the list of selected candidates. So GD is just a process of elimination, guys. So for you, why you should understand about the importance of GD. You have to apply certain strategies not to be in the list of eliminated candidate. You should always try your level best to be in the list of selected candidates. Point the strategies. When you are going to participate in any GD, and when you understood that it is just a process of elimination, so you should apply certain action plans. And all those action plans are supposed to be set together. Why we need to come up with action plans? Why? Because when particular one plan would not happen, then I should be ready with the different plan. So that's why I named all those plans as action plans. So action plan A. What is action plan A? Action plan A says that you have to be the initiator at any cost. The moment you get the topic, you all must be getting certain time to think for the topic. At that particular time, you have to find out a proper time to jot down all those things which is coming to your mind. If you have got a sheet of paper, write it there. If you are not having a sheet of paper, just frame those ideas in your mind that what you're going to speak. But your action plan A says that you have to be the initiator at any cost. Why? Because the moment you become the initiator, you have got a privilege to address the topic in front of everyone. And you have got this privilege gives you certain time limit, at least for 15 to 20 seconds, at least for 10 to 15 seconds, I should say, you are able to address the topic. I'll give you the example, like how you address the topic. You just address like, good morning, everyone. We all are gathered here to discuss on this particular topic. You have to start with high tone. Good morning, everyone. We all are gathered here to discuss on this particular topic. And you have to add one introducer, such as far as my view is concerned, as far as my knowledge is concerned, I have this point of view in this point. And then you can add your point. Similarly, you all can attach your own introducers. Like, as I have used, as far as my view is concerned, as far as my knowledge is concerned, you can attach your own introducers, ready-made introducers. And this is how you have to apply your action plan A. Action plan A talks about, guys, frankly speaking, it only talks about at any cost, I have to be the initiator. Okay, now moving towards the action plan B. When I could not apply my action plan A, so of course, all of you are going to be ready with your all action plans. So of course, only one person will be able to apply his or her action plan A. So when one person applied his action plan A, so you could not apply, so you should be ready with your action plan B. Action plan B talks about, I have to be the second speaker. How I can be the second speaker? First of all, realize that I have to be the second speaker at any cost. I could not apply my action plan A. I'll quickly move to the action plan B. Okay, I have to be very, very attentive when I have to apply my action plan B. Attentiveness is really very required. You have to observe the person who started speaking first, who initiated the topic. Obviously, that person is not going to speak for more duration because that person would be having other action plans ready. You guys, I'll talk about that plan of the person who could utilize the action plan A later. Now here I'm dealing with action plan B. So action plan B says that I have to be the second speaker. For that, I have to be very attentive. I have to observe the person who started first. I have to see his or her eyes, how the person is speaking, at what time that person is going to take the pause. So I should not wait for the pause. I should be interrupting just before he takes or she takes the pause, just before 5, 10 seconds. And for that, you have to be attentive. You have to be manipulative when that person is going to take the pause. So you have to be really very attentive. Now, moving towards the action plan C. Action plan C is almost similar to B. Why I'm talking about that? Because obviously, one person could apply action plan B, action plan A, then the second person could apply action plan B. So I should not be stopping myself. Oh, I could not apply my action plan B, action plan A, my action plan B. I should be demotivated. No, guys, you have to be completely attentive throughout the process. So action plan C is almost similar to B. And what B says, you have to be the second speaker. So C says, you have to be the third speaker. Third speaker, you have to grab that opportunity. And the similar kind of process you have to do. You have to observe the second speaker very, very attentively. How, when the person is going to take the pause. Now moving towards the action plan D. Action plan D, I already told you, when I applied, and some of you could apply your action plan A. So obviously, you would not be relaxing that I became the initiator, I just grab it. I will be in the selected list. No. I should be ready with my other action plan. Why? Because I could utilize my action plan A. So I would be keeping few points to introduce by me later. So I will be ready with my action plan D, which says that after 3-4 speaker, after 2-3 speakers, again, I have to interrupt. Again, I have to speak. So for that, you have to be attentive. It's not like that you have utilized your action plan A, now you should be relaxed. You should be listening to each of the points. Then only you will add some of the points in your content whenever you just interrupt and whenever you just speak. Guys, this circle goes all the time. You have to be all time very much attentive. Like obviously, like action plan B, if I could apply my action plan B, so obviously my other action plan will be ready. I would not be speaking all the points or at that particular moment. So I will be keeping certain topic, certain points to come up later. So again, when I'll be coming up, I'll be waiting for at least two to three speakers to speak. Then again, I'll interrupt. This is why I have circled the process, action plan A, action plan B, action plan C, action plan D. Now, guys, the strategies, if you are going to apply these strategies, I'm 110% sure you would be able to crack the GD. But you have to make sure that you should be ready with your all action plans. Now, guys, moving towards my last point, as you can see, some more tips. So I have given only two tips. Never be judgmental about any topic. It may be a little bit confusing to some of you. Okay. But for me, why we should not be judgmental? The moment we become judgmental about a particular topic, we just build up a kind of wall in front of us. And the moment the wall is built up, like we are not able to see the other side. So we have to see both the perspective and we have to generate our parallel processing ability. So until unless you do not see both the perspective of a topic, you would not be able to talk about both the perspective. You would not be able to generate your parallel processing ability. And as a leader, because they are also supposed to see your leadership skills, your team building skills. So if you're not able to have a balanced attitude, then you would not be able to speak more and more. And in order to speak more on topic, on any of the topic, you are not supposed to be judgmental. You have to choose out both the perspective. And the last one is do not involve your ideologies at that time. Some of you may be confused about the ideologies. And in these days, guys, when we do talk about ideologies, the way the media is in front of us, you know about the media. So whole media in these days are divided into two parts, pro, against. And both the parts are at the high. So the way the media, the news are presented in front of us, it really attracts or attacks our ideologies. So then we also become pro and anti. At the time of GD, frankly speaking, guys, do not involve that. Do not involve your ideologies at that time. Set aside your ideologies. When you have that parallel processing ability, you'd be able to see both the perspective and the organization also wants that. They do not want your ideologies. Whosoever you like, that is your personal life. You should not be showing the ideologies in particular corporate scenario. They don't want to see that, frankly speaking, guys. So there are lots of examples when people just showcase their ideologies, and they why you should also not involve your ideologies, because the moment you involve your ideologies, you become emotional, and you become emotionally negative way most of the time, and then you become aggressive, and aggressiveness is not very much required. Too much aggressiveness is not very much required at the time of GD. We just could learn the importance of GD for student, why it is really very important, we could learn. Okay, and we just talked about the elimination and all. And the second thing we learned about different strategies, plan A, plan B, plan C, and plan D. And I just introduced two tips, never be judgmental on the topic, and then do not involve your ideologies. So hope you liked the session. And guys, we are again going to come back with more knowledge on GD, because GD is really very vast thing. Lots of things are there. So thank you so much, guys. This is how I end my session. Okay. Thank you so much.